Ever wondered what makes a French woman French? A certain je ne sais quoi? And a lot more. Follow in the footsteps of storyteller Edith de Belleville, a native Parisian who brings to life the hidden histories of the great women who shaped and influenced the France we know today. In each part of this radio series, Edith will take you to a different arrondissement of Paris with plenty of anecdotes and secrets to share. Ooh la la, mais oui. Tell us about Kiki de Montparnasse. Who was Kiki?
I will start with a quotation of Hemingway, because she lived during the time of Hemingway in the roaring 20s in Paris, in Montparnasse. And Hemingway, who only wrote twice the introduction of a book, one was for a bartender and the other one was for Kiki de Montparnasse, he wrote, Kiki dominated the era of Montparnasse more than Queen Victoria ever dominated the Victorian era. You cannot tell better than Hemingway.
The man has a way with words.
Yes, and to talk about Kiki herself, she was born in 1901 in Châtillon-sur-Seine in Burgundy. She arrived in Paris. She comes from a very poor family, illegitimate, and it's a grandmother who raised her. She went to Paris to follow her mother when she was about 14, 16. And finally, I sum up, she arrived in Montparnasse and she met the artist and she said, this is what I want to do. The painter who made her famous was Fujita, the Japanese. Fujita, he did paint her, and the painting, if you want to see it, is the Museum of Modern Art in Paris. So she's the symbol of a creative world of Montparnasse, which was like Henry Miller said, the navel of the world, you know, Carrefour Vavin, Metro Vavin, Montparnasse, for people who would like to come to visit us. And many cafes and many artists, Man Ray, Picasso, Soutine, Modigliani before he died before, but all the really where the modern art was created. And she was the muse, but not only a muse, she was an artist, she was a singer. The men were watching her and the men were painting her and were taking pictures of her. She was more than beautiful, because when you see a face, that's very interesting. She was changing a lot. The physique was changing a lot. You can tell she was classically beautiful, you know. But Man Ray, who took picture of her, said she had a face, a pearl face. And sometimes she was not very good looking, sometimes she was nice, but she had something. She was more than a muse, because she had a great personality, symbol of modernity and freedom. Because in the 20s, you know, when you were a woman, men were, you were allowed to be seen, but not to act, not to paint, not to be artist. And she was more than a muse, because she did things and she inspired artists. And it's funny, I read that Man Ray, he became famous thanks to Kiki, and his French, he improved his French thanks to Kiki too. There is a famous picture called in English The Violin of Ingres, Le Violon d'Ingres, where you have a big, maybe only you can describe more than me, because your English is a little better than me.
Well, it's a portrait of Kiki, but seen from the back. And her back, actually, her naked back, becomes a violin, with the F-holes of the violin painted into her back. And the curves of her back resemble that of a voluptuous violin.
Yes, because she was a voluptuous woman, the sensual body. So this photography is the photography the most sold in the world. Yes, very popular. And it became the symbol of a surrealism, because it was printed in the newspaper Literature in 1924. Ingres is a artist, painter from 19th century, and Man Ray, who visited the Louvre, was inspired by the painting of Ingres, the Turkish bath. So if you go to visit the Louvre, go to see the Turkish bath of Ingres. And now you're going to tell me, as my Gabriela, my Brazilian friend, asked me yesterday in the metro, Edith, why is it called a violin? She doesn't look like a violin. She looks like the big instrument. instrument, not the cello.
The double bass?
The double bass. And I say, Gabriella, thank you to ask me this question. Why? Why it's the violin and not the double bass of Ingres? Well, first you see the image of the violin or double bass, you understand, the image of the woman singing as an instrument you play with. The second meaning, it's because Ingres, his hobby was playing violin. His father was a musician. And in French, if I want to know what is your hobby, I will ask you, what is your Ingres violin? Le violon d'Ingres in French means...
It's an expression.
Absolutely, an expression about the hobby. So if you don't know the expression, you don't understand why Man Ray used the word violin and not double bass, because the idea of surrealism is playing on the words. So inspiration Ingres, and she looks like a violin, and the French expression violon d'Ingres, you see. And she became famous. She was so famous because she was more famous than Man Ray, that people were coming, all the tourists, they were coming to Paris to see the Eiffel Tower and Kiki de Montparnasse. Yes, because she was really the symbol. For me, she's the symbol of the Parisian woman. You know, she was audacious, outspoken, sensual, funny. She was singing audacious songs. Mm-hmm. And more than this, she had a great generosity, extremely nice. She was always saying, if I have a raw onion, bread, and a red wine, I will always find a friend to offer to me, which I think now you couldn't say this. You know,
How did she get the name Kiki? Who gave her this nickname? Because her name is Alice, isn't it?
Yes. Alice Prin. Yes, it's her first lover, Mengiski, who was a painter in Montparnasse. It's the first one who took her because she was poor. He was calling her in Greek Aliki. It's the nickname for Alice, Aliki. And from Aliki became Kiki. And this is the nickname she had.
Now, Kiki was a very free woman in her time.
Yes, absolutely. Maybe for me, she's one of my inspiration, Parisian woman, because she could have chose to marry a well-off man. You know, even I think the ambassador of Mexico proposed to marry her, and she didn't want. She refused. She preferred to choose her lovers, to live a life. She even did what we would call now pornographic pictures. Yes, but at this time, you have to think it was not pornographic. It was the freedom. You know, people were drinking, having drugs. And she did it for the good reasons. It was to give money to the newspaper literature, because the newspaper literature was founded by the Pope or the leader of the Surrealism. I told you that this famous picture is the symbol of the Surrealism. But you're going to ask me, yes, but what is Surrealism? Yes.
What is Surrealism? Please, eat it.
Yeah, what is it? First, it's Guillaume Apollinaire, a poet who invented the word about one of his theater play. And the idea is to dream, to mix the dream and the reality, using no borders between something from the dream and something from the reality. It was founded by André Breton, who was a male nurse. He was working in a psychiatry, so he was very interested in Freud, in the psychoanalysis, and he used it and surrealism, the idea. So you put things in reality, reminds you the dream, and they invented what you call automatic writing. You write everything because it's the concept of unconscious. You know, it's linked with the psychoanalysis. This movement comes from another movement created during the First World War, because you have to think that in the 20s, it was the roaring 20s, because people wanted to leave, you know, so you had many people who died, soldiers, many widows, and people wanted to have fun. So the Surrealist comes from another movement that we call the movement Dada. And please don't call Dadaism, because if you say Dadaism, it means you didn't understand the philosophy of the movement Dada. because the Dada movement is something absurd against the war. It was something crazy, and they didn't want to be in all the movement in ism, like impressionism, cubism, etc. So if you say Dadaism, it means you don't know the movement, okay? So don't use it. It's my friend Guillaume, who is an eminent and qualified guide in Le Louvre, who explained it to me. So that's about literature movement. So Man Ray is linked to the Surrealist movement. If I tell you Surrealism, immediately you have the idea of Salvador Dali. Because when you see the painting of Dali, you understand what is Surrealism. Or the movies of Luis Buñuel. But at the beginning, it was literature. It was André Breton. It was books. And after, all the media, like movies, painting, music, photography, and now you have Man Ray, were linked to this movement on poetry and unconscious.
Mm-hmm. Now, Kiki de Montparnasse made some films.
Yeah, well, she did collaborate, Fernand Léger or Man Ray and surrealistic movies, but they didn't put her name, you know. That's the man how they were, using her and taking advantage of her. You can check on the internet. You have L'Étoile de Mer, which is a surrealistic movie made by Man Ray, or other short movies when you can see her.
So experimental films as such.
Yes, and Man Ray had to put a body blurred because of, you know, it was
bad. Oh, because it was considered like pornographic.
Absolutely. And, you know, it took me a long time because I do a guided visit about Montparnasse, and it took me a long time to find this pornographic, we call pornographic pictures, which it's very funny because she has a very specific mouth and you can recognize her mouth. It's very, it's not cute, I wouldn't say this, but you can, it's pornographic picture with Man Ray, but you can recognize her mouth on the pictures. It's cute. I forgot to say she went to Hollywood in 1930, but you know, Kiki de Montparnasse could only live in Montparnasse because it was a big, it didn't work at all in Hollywood. She went to United States. She was so famous, you know. She tried to be a movie star, but it didn't work. Well, mostly because even her English was worse than mine, so she couldn't do anything. And Kiki was only in Montparnasse, you know. She was really the product of where she was living, Montparnasse, Paris.
And there were these cafes that she used to hang out in, La Rotonde, for example. Tell us about some of the places she used to meet and greet people.
Yes, yes, I did a video about this. If you want to watch exactly the cafe where she was, in the roaring 20s in Montparnasse, mm-hmm. and you can see the cafe. Yeah, it was the, for example, it's fun, it's what I say in my video. If you go in La Rotonde, she was washing her feet in the toilets. Because Fujita, you're not allowed to laugh. Because Fujita was a Japanese, he was horrified when he saw feet. And he was very shocked when he saw that.
Because she had dirty feet?
She had dirty feet. And you know, he said, you're not allowed to come in my house with these feet. So she was washing her feet in the cafe in La Rotonde, where you put your bottom on the toilet. She was putting a feet.
And there's a story about a hat. I'm not sure if it was the Coupole or La Rotonde, but she went into one of these brasseries and they said, you can't come in here, madame, you're not wearing a hat. Tell us about that.
This is how she met Man Ray. It was not in La Coupole, it was in a cafe which doesn't exist anymore. And she arrived and the owner said, madame, you cannot come if you don't have a hat. She became very angry and she said, yes, but c'est salope d'Américaine, bitches Americans, they don't have a hat and you let them come in. And the owner, she almost did fight with a guy, and Man Ray was there with another Russian artist, and he said, calm down, and he paid for her. And the owner, when he saw that he was American, because American were, you have to remember, there were 7 boats each day coming from New York to Le Havre, full of Americans. So when he saw that Man Ray was American, had more money, the owner was nicer. But this is how he met Kiki, you know, and he was fascinated by her temper, because she had temper, you know, and by her beauty too, because she was beautiful. Even if her face was not conventional, she was very lively. That's it.
Now, she also at one stage, was she not the owner of a cabaret that she changed the name or something? Tell us about the cabaret thing.
Yes, she had Le Jockey. She was animating Le Jockey. Now it's a building in Montparnasse. I think it's kind of post office now. And she was popular. You have a famous picture with Man Ray, Tristan Tzara, all the people, very, you know, fun. They had fun. They were dancing. And, you know, if you wanted to dance tango, for example, in the 20s, you couldn't do it in New York. You were coming to Paris. Even the police was not allowed to come to Montparnasse. That's why you had so much drug dealers with cocaine. The chief of the police liked very much artists. He bought many, many paintings, and his order was, let them alone. Give them a break. The order, the artists were never under arrest. So that's why they could use cocaine and drink and have fun, sex and everything. It was a district where you didn't have law in purpose, because the Parisian understood that it was a cradle of creation, imagination. Mm-hmm. And there were many, many, many tourists. I told you, many Americans. It's really a fantasy for Americans still now, the Roaring Twenties and Montparnasse. So they understood that they could create their own world, so they could do anything they wanted. Mm-hmm. Kiki, her problem, because she has a dark soul, her problem was alcohol and drug. Mm-hmm. But you have to remind that in this time we didn't know the effect of alcohol or drug. Cocteau was taking opium, you know, many, many artists were taking drug and drinking. Mm-hmm. So probably it helped her, because she was singing and she said, I cannot sing if I didn't drink. And she was very, I call her Kiki the Kinky, because she was extremely, yeah, kinky. She was funny. She never wore underwear, for example. So when she was dancing, a friend told Thérèse, hey, maybe it would be a good idea to put something, because, you know, it's interesting, but better if you have underwear. And what is funny, or maybe surrealistic, that if you, on the internet, if you type Kiki de Montparnasse, immediately you will have, you know what you will have? A brand of underwear.
Lingerie
from New York. Expensive, chic, and I wrote to the brand, to the people, and I did insult them, but they never answered me. They say, who is this crazy nuts French woman? Say, how dare you to use the name of Kiki Montparnasse, especially using for lingerie, knowing she never wore lingerie, and you put prices that she wouldn't. She was very simple, you know. She was very down to earth. That's why she never liked the surrealistic movement, because she was saying to André Breton, are you talking always about love, but when do you make love? Never. You know, she was more in the action. And she had a specificity. She had no pubic hair. No, so she had a huge complex. And on the paint...
You mean naturally? She didn't get it shaved off?
Yeah, naturally. Now she would be very fashionable.
Yeah, I was going to say, yes. Yeah, Brazilian.
No, but no, at this time it was a complex. And the artists didn't like it, you know. They wanted a real woman. It was a specificity. So she's really a very, very interesting woman. The problem was information about her. She wrote her memories, and it was immediately banned by US because, of course, it was too sexual. And only two biographies were written, one by an American, Bill Cluver, and another one by a Danish woman, Lou Molgaard, that I met, a very good-looking woman. And
you have the book right here with a, it's dedicated to you. It's got a special message inside, and it says, pour la ravissante Edith, to the beautiful, ravishing Edith, qui me rappelle Kiki, who reminds me of Kiki, avec mes amitiés les plus sincères. So with my most sincere friendship, and signed by the author Lou Molgaard. Kiki de Montparnasse, Reine de Montparnasse, the Queen of Montparnasse.
Yes, she became Queen of Montparnasse. She was 28 years old or 29, and she was elected and she became the Queen. She was really the Queen of Montparnasse. What is pity that nobody knows her, everybody knows the pictures. What is interesting, that it's really a big love between Man Ray. He became famous thanks to her, you know? The big love between Man Ray and Kiki. And when you read the memory, she never speak about Man Ray. Why? Probably because it was a strong love story. Because if you read the memory of Man Ray, you understand it was really the woman of his life. So of the problem of Kiki, that she became fat, weight was 80 kilos, drug, alcohol, and she was people let her down. It's a very sad story, you know. After using her as a model muse, they all did let her down, and she died at 51, very poor, probably because of the alcohol and the drug. So that's why her home, she's very modern because she chose a family. And her family were the artists. Mm. That's why she's so have affection for her tenderness because of this, mostly.
So she was a very generous person. She shared herself with everyone.
Yeah, she shared herself, her body with all the men. No, and she was very outspoken and very generous. Even when she didn't have money, she was sharing what she had. That's the problem, you know. She did end badly because of drug and alcohol, and you know, in 1929, the crisis, all the American went back, and she did end badly too because she had no education, you know. She had a lot of money, but she didn't know what to do with it. Lack of education, that's a problem.
So Edith, tell us how Kiki has been such a great influence to women, even today, all these many years later.
I will tell what Katten Müller, the woman who drew the cartoon, translated in 15 languages. They won many awards. And I will tell what she said. She said, why I liked so much Kiki, because she's really, for me, an audacious woman and a free woman, liberté. This is the word she always had. She was saying, I will never do three times the same things on a row, you know, because she wanted something.
To take risks?
Absolutely, risk, and she was doing what she wanted, having men, and she had this great character, maybe not always easy. And she was, you know, in a world now which is so, how do you say in English? Everybody, you know, you have the same shop, Zara, Gap, and everything, everybody look like everybody. She was exactly against this, you know? So
she was a real individual. Unique.
Yeah, unique and a free woman. This is that's why for me she's one of my inspiration women too. She's really the Parisian woman that we have in mind, you know, outspoken and not always very friendly. I mean, when I say friendly, she say what she thinks. But true woman.
What would she make of social media today, do you think? Would she have been a queen of social media? Would she have been someone who would be an influential person, if we imagine her transported into today's world?
But she would be the it girl, absolutely. Forget all the skinny women you see on Facebook. She would be one. Because what is interesting, she didn't have the body. In the 20s, the body you had to have when you were a woman was... you look like very slim, you know, androgynous body, and she didn't have. She had hips, she had...
She was curvy.
Exactly. So I would say she would be the hit girl, she would be the muse of all the modern artists.
And fashion designers and...
Yes, yeah. definitely, because she was not only a body, she was really a personality.
You have a little song for us, I believe.
No, I have to say a few words about this song. The two famous songs, it's a song in the same time of Kiki Montparnasse in the 1920s, and it's Miss Tinguette who sang it. And Miss Tinguette was the big rival of Josephine Baker. That was the two, you know, enemies in
the cabaret world.
Absolutely. So Kiki Montparnasse was coming from Burgundy, as I told you. And she has a common point with the writer, Colette, because Colette was coming from Burgundy. Burgundy, too, Bourgogne. And this is where I had my degree to be French teacher to foreigners, by the way. And Dijon, so I like very much Burgundy. And the specificity of the people, they used to rouler les R, Paris, c'est Paris.
Rolling their R's.
Yes, like Colette when she was talking, and Kiki, she was talking like this. So few words about the song. That's a song probably which tells the love story between Miss Tinguette and Maurice Chevalier for 10 days. They were lovers. And the song says the woman, she's madly in love. She has a man under the skin. He beats her. He takes her money. But she still loves him. This is the love story. Okay, I start. Sur cette terre, ma seule joie, mon seul bonheur, c'est mon homme. J'ai donné tout ce que j'ai, mon amour et tout mon cœur à mon homme. Et même la nuit, quand je rêve, c'est de lui, de mon homme. Ce n'est pas qu'il soit beau, qu'il soit riche ni costaud, mais je l'aime. Cet idiot, il me fout des coups, il me prend mes sous. Je suis à bout, mais malgré tout, que voulez-vous? Je l'ai tellement dans la peau, j'en deviens marteau. Dès qu'il s'approche, c'est fini, je suis à lui. Quand ses yeux sur moi se posent, ça me rend toute chose. Je l'ai tellement dans la peau qu'au moindre mot, il me ferait faire n'importe quoi. Je tuerais ma foi, je sens qu'il me rendrait infâme. Mais je ne suis qu'une femme et je l'ai tellement dans la peau.